It's a pretty sophisticated process. We're not wildlife moms, but we try the best we can.
Rarely easy, often rewarding.
Sometimes it involves a lot of wild goose chases, literally.
When it comes to rescuing, rehabbing, and releasing an injured animal, Wildlife Rehab Inc. is here to help.
It's difficult sometimes because as soon as you go, you're the triage person.
They're based in the triad, but respond all over the state, anything from birds to mammals to reptiles.
If they're bleeding, you fix it as well as you can and then get them to the rehab or the vet as soon as you can.
Last year, they took in more than 3,000 animals, and those figures have gone up year by year.
And it is rising. I mean, we never go fewer than we did the year before, so it's a big deal.
Part of the reason is everything new. New roads, new businesses, new houses.
There he goes.
Last week, they picked up a hawk, which was injured in a new development.
You wonder if that was a hawk that had always been there, and then all of a sudden, he can't fly his normal path.
Turkey, geese, and deer calls have all increased. Michele Poe is the organization's president and an expert with fawns, who says urgency kicks in when she needs to treat their wounds.
That urgency then goes to worry. That I've done the right thing and that the animal is going to survive.
It's something they don't want the untrained to try.
Their intentions are good. Sometimes that backfires.
They say if you do come across a wounded or endangered animal, try to get them to a dark, quiet, cool place.
Call a rehabber first. Do not feed. Do not give them anything to eat or drink.
This year, the amount of animals they can treat is going up too. Previously, they weren't allowed to help rabies-prone species, raccoons, foxes, bats, because of North Carolina law. Now they can.
It's a good way to protect us and protect the community.
Not all of them can be saved, but when they are.
It was worth the time and the effort and the tears and the laughs to get that animal back in his natural environment.
Last year, Poe took in a fawn, which usually take 5 to 6 months to rehab.
I had a fawn that had a leg injury.
Broken legs are the most common injury they see in them.
This fawn had the will to live.
It took several weeks, but eventually Mamie, as she came to be called, stood up, and a couple weeks later was back to normal.
To see them go is also sad because they're not a part of my life anymore.
The pain of goodbye, worth it for the memories of the good times and the gratification of saving a life.
Just to see him go from dragging his back leg to running on it is a memory I'll never forget.